Ladies and gentlemen, the big man, Seru Rabeni. And so, to our final game in his memory this afternoon, it's our elite performance professional, top-end, all bells and whistles match. And again, it's the DB Pirates against HK Barbarians. And some of these names may be appearing. Ido, Emerson, Kyle, Faisal, Blaggy, Zach, Henry, Joe, Oscar, Andy, Tavita, Leo, Mike, Hogan, Neil, Brad, Moose, Fraser, George, Mikey, Benny, Irish John, Jamie, James, Aaron, Comey, Antoine, Anthony, Max, Lee, Katsuya, Jack, John, Bryce, Cameron, Paul, Dave, Ben, Tim, Gaz, Dave, Scotty, and another Dave. There are at least five clubs represented out here today. Our referee is the one and only Ralph Ibema. It's going to be a great match. Our third and final one of the day. Let's get ready for some rugby.
Thank you.
The conversion is wide. Pirates 5, Barbarians yet to score.
Yeah, yeah! Come on! Good! Thank you.
The conversion is wide. The scores remain tied at 5 apiece. And if I'm not mistaken, that's half time. To continue the story of Seru's rugby career, internationally he appeared for Fiji's renowned Sevens team in the 2002 Commonwealth Games in Manchester and twice at the Hong Kong Sevens, 1999 and 2000. In 15 aside, his first and last test appearances were against Japan in Tokyo in May 2000 and in Lautoka in July 2001. And he won 30 caps in total for Fiji and 9 for the Pacific Islanders. Seru played in the first of his two World Cups in Australia in 2003, appearing in 4 matches. 4 years later, he was a star of Fiji's momentous campaign at the 2007 tournament in France, where he played in 4 of his country's 5 matches, including the famous pool stage win over Wales in Nantes and the quarterfinal defeat to the eventual champion South Africa in Marseille. After leaving Leeds, he played for the French clubs La Rochelle, being named in a multinational top 14 dream team alongside Toulon's Johnny Wilkinson at the end of 2010, and Mont-de-Marsan until 2013, and also appeared for the Barbarians in 2011, before he began his coaching career. Firstly with a college team in the US, and then of course as player coach with Discovery Bay Pirates here in Hong Kong, where he was studying for a Master's in Sports Marketing and Business Management. This was part of Seru's efforts to tackle social issues in his homeland. He described himself as having been raised on the poverty line in the village of Nasolo, and the Daily Mail reported in 2009 how the softly spoken Fijian was supporting projects aimed at alleviating poverty on Vanua Levu with the improvement of water and electricity supplies and community buildings. He also spoke of the need for better education. "I can't get away from the village, it is my life," he said at the time. "If I had millions, I would definitely change it overnight." One half of rugby still to go. It's been a wonderful afternoon so far in memory of the great Seru Rabeni. Don't forget, all today's activities are being live streamed on the HKRU YouTube site, Seru Rabeni Memorial Games. And we're off, second half, DB Pirates, Hong Kong Barbarians, 5 points apiece. That's a try to the Pirates and a successful conversion. That stretches their lead out now to 12 points to 5. Slight correction to the score, it's actually 17-5. I was momentarily distracted earlier on.
Yeah. Thank you. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, the referee blows the whistle for the end of the match, and it's a first victory of the day to DB Pirates, winners over the Barbarians by 29 points to 12. Ladies and gentlemen, we started the day with a round of applause and we're going to end it in the same way. Firstly, thanks to the Hong Kong Football Club for their generous hosting this afternoon. Also to the referees and officials, to Steve Keane and the DB Pirates Committee, to all of you for your support, and finally to show our thanks for the life of Seru Rabeni, a great man whose legacy we will all work together to support in the months and years to come. Please put your hands together one last time.
We've played three.
Oh,
is it?
Hold it on.